Good day everyone, and welcome to part 3 of our webinar series on VLANs in DrayTek VigorSwitches. This is a continuation of our webinar series covering VLANs in DrayTek products. My name is Java, and I'm a technical sales specialist at DrayTek Australia New Zealand. In today's session, we go a step further and build up on what we've learned in our previous webinar. We looked at the VLAN functions in DrayTek Layer 2 VigorSwitches. It's time to look at the higher end VigorSwitches and discuss Layer 2 Plus functions, which include some basic routing as well as ONVIF functions. If you have any questions during the video, simply comment in the chat box on the right of your screen and stick around at the end for a 5-minute Q&A. And if you're watching this after the live premiere, please comment below or send us an email at sales@draytech.com.au. All of the features we'll discuss today are available in DrayTek's Layer 2 Plus VigorSwitches, which include the VigorSwitch G2280X, P2280X, G2540X, and P2540X. These switches are available in both 28-port and 54-port versions and also include 10 gigabit Ethernet ports. They're also available in either PoE or non-PoE versions. I'll include links to product information in the video description below. All right, so it's time to begin. Let's review the Layer 2 Plus functions, which are available in higher-end VigorSwitches. I'll be starting off by explaining the differences between Layer 2 and Layer 2 Plus VigorSwitches. Then we'll check out the Layer 2 Plus VLAN interface, VLAN routing, and setting up the DHCP server by using the bind IP to MAC feature. Now here's a diagram about the different layers in the OSI model, which I'm sure you've seen before. As we know, Layer 2 switches operate in the data link layer of the OSI model, so is only concerned with MAC addresses and not IP addresses. Layer 2 Plus switches will handle both the Layer 2 functions as well as some Layer 3 functions in the network layer. So they can deal with IP addresses as well as some router functions. Routers also operate in the transport layer, so have complete Layer 3 features as well as some WAN techniques. While it does not include the complete Layer 3 features of a router, a Layer 2 Plus VigorSwitch can reduce the load on the main router by handling inter-VLAN routing as well as DHCP services. In Layer 2 Plus VigorSwitches, we have a virtual interface for each VLAN within the switch. For each of these interfaces, we can assign an IP address and subnet mask similar to what you do in a router. In addition, the Layer 2 Plus VigorSwitch maintains a routing table with connected routes of each VLAN interface. This is required when a device in one VLAN needs to communicate with another device in another VLAN. The switch will provide inter-LAN routing, thereby eliminating the need for data traffic to be sent to the router to provide communication between the VLANs. In a large network, as shown in this diagram, much of the data traffic flows between devices or servers on the local network. Not so much traffic goes out to the internet. For instance, your IP cameras store videos to a local NVR, IP phones register to a PBX, and PC clients access documents and files on the local file server. This can help to improve network performance and also reduce the need to have a higher-end router to handle local traffic. So in some cases, a smaller router is all that's required to access the internet. As you can imagine, there are a number of benefits of using Layer 2 Plus VigorSwitches, which provide both VLAN routing functionality as well as DHCP services. Traffic on the LAN is received by the VigorSwitch before it reaches the router, so it helps to share and reduce the router's load. If the router should go offline for some reason, the local network can still work uninterrupted since the VigorSwitch will continue to provide routing and DHCP services. The DHCP server can assign dynamic IP addresses for up to 8 VLANs. Finally, VLAN routing will support up to 512 routes, which is usually more than enough for a medium-sized network. Let me give you a quick demonstration of VLAN routing using the network topology shown in this diagram. The VigorSwitch P2540X has two VLANs configured. VLAN 20 is shown in green, and VLAN 30 shown in blue. And each VLAN is associated with an IP subnet. We want devices in each of these VLANs to be able to communicate with devices in the other VLAN through the VigorSwitch VLAN routing. To configure VLAN routing, we first need to go to the web interface of the VigorSwitch. We go to the property menu and enable the VLAN routing function. Then we have to assign an IP address for each VLAN ID. When configuring the IP address, we have to make sure it doesn't clash with the LAN IP address set up in the router, otherwise it'll cause a conflict. We can do this by going to the router LAN settings and checking that the IP addresses are different. For VLAN 20, we had the switch LAN IP as 192.168.20.254. And in the router, it's 192.168.20.1. In the router's DHCP setting, we also need to configure the gateway IP address to point to the VigorSwitch, so the switch will handle the routing. Similarly, for LAN 3, we'll do the same. My PC is connected to VLAN 30 and can get an IP address in the LAN 3 subnet. Now we try to ping a device in VLAN 20, which is using LAN 2 subnet. Let's try to ping this IP address 192.168.20.11. Nice. We get a ping reply from this address, so inter VLAN routing is working. So this is how VLAN routing works. The next item we'll look at today is the DHCP server function in Layer 2 Plus VigorSwitches. The DHCP server only needs to be configured on the core switch, and this will also help to reduce the workload on the main internet router. The devices that are connected to the edge switches will be assigned an IP address from the core switch. In addition, the bind IP to MAC function can also be used to assign a static IP address for important devices. Here's the DHCP server configuration menu in the Layer 2 Plus VigorSwitch. The settings available are similar to what you see in a Vigor router and is applied to a particular VLAN. As I mentioned, the bind IP to MAC function can be used for reserving IP addresses for important devices that most users will access frequently. It also helps to prevent end users from configuring their IP addresses by themselves, which may cause IP conflicts. The maximum table size is 512 entries. A useful feature available in VigorSwitches is ONVIF. This term is an abbreviation for Open Network Video Interface Forum. This is a global and open industry forum which created a standard for how IP products within video surveillance and other physical security areas can communicate with each other. In DrayTek VigorSwitches, ONVIF devices are recognized in different VLANs. It can also display the surveillance topology and provides a user interface for video streaming and device maintenance. The centralized hierarchical view displays the ONVIF devices in the status view. As shown here, the blue icons are the IP cameras that are connected to the switch, and the gray icons are the NVRs. Another handy feature is the ability to view real-time video of specified IP cameras directly from the VigorSwitch menu page, as you can see here. It allows the network administrator to monitor and control environments without having to log into each IP camera or the NVR. The system admin can remotely configure time settings and reboot the devices, including IP cameras and NVRs that are managed by VigorSwitch. This page on your screen displays device information, such as its name and online status, along with time and date and the device action for a selected IP device. Other configuration settings available are for ping checking IP cameras and NVRs. It is indeed difficult to manage several IP cameras across different locations and customers, not to mention to keep monitoring on which camera stops functioning. Another handy feature is that the VigorSwitch keeps pinging on the ONVIF IP cameras, taking snapshots from them periodically. When the camera stops responding, the VigorSwitch will send out an email alert with the latest snapshot. This will help the system administrator to quickly locate which camera has failed. With PoE VigorSwitches, there is an option to automatically power cycle the particular port to reboot the camera and attempt to get it back online. So, to summarize today, we looked at Layer 2 Plus functions in VigorSwitches, which included VLAN routing and DHCP server, as well as ONVIF feature to monitor and manage video surveillance devices on the network. For more information about DrayTek products, please check out our website, www.draytek.com.au, or send us an email to sales@draytek.com.au, or give us a call on 02-98-388-99. Don't forget to like and subscribe below. And if you'd like a notification of new premiere videos we're about to launch, or anytime we put up a new video, please give the bell a click too. Thank you for joining in today's session. That's it for me. But please stay tuned. Our technical team will be answering questions in the live chat on the right of your screen for the next 5 minutes. Thank you very much for your time today. Until we meet again. Goodbye.